Hello, you guys. I've actually been asked to give a couple of video demonstrations on some colors. So I'm going to try to do, I guess, just make up a couple of colors and try to end up having a more accurate description of how I ended up getting to those colors. So what I ended up doing was I got this little scale. I got it from online. It was a fairly cheap scale. I think it was like $20, but I'm going to try my best to try to get a weight ratio. So that way people can end up using the weights if they want an accurate, more accurate description of what powders ended up going into the alcohol or water solution that I'm gonna be preparing. So the first thing I'm gonna do is start this thing up. And this is probably gonna be a little bit longer video. The 1/8 teaspoon. I'm gonna just get a heaping 1/8 teaspoon, and my actual weight target is going to be about 0.4, maybe a little bit more than 0.4. So we got 0.35 there. So there's 0.4. I'm going to go 0.4. Five. That sounds good. I'm gonna end up doing, I'm using an isopropyl alcohol. I have a 91% isopropyl alcohol just for the demonstrations of this video. You could probably end up using a 70% isopropyl alcohol. I don't think that there's very much difference other than the content of the alcohol, the concentration of that. I'm just taking a regular glass, I'm taking 4 ounces. You're not gonna be able to see that, but I have 4 ounces, 1/2 cup of isopropyl alcohol. And I'm just adding it to this glass. And now I'm going to take this blue dye. I'm also using the Keda Dye stain kit. It comes with 5 colors, black, blue, yellow, red, and brown. Has a pretty good instruction packet with it. I'm also gonna end up using a lacquer. This is just a Valspar rattle can. It's something that I have laying around, so I'm gonna use it. So I'm gonna end up mixing this around a little bit just to get a little swirl going on, get these dyes dissolving. Now, when you end up using these aniline powders with alcohol or the solvents, it ends up taking a little bit longer for these to end up dissolving. But I just like the results of using the isopropyl alcohol. And then I'm also gonna add, this is about 1/4 cup of hot distilled water. Just because I like to use the both combination. And the reason I like to do that is because it kind of gives me the best of both worlds. It's this dye stain, when I end up applying it to the wood, is not gonna dry so fast that it's gonna leave lap marks and doesn't allow for a decent penetration into the wood. The thing with dyes is that you want it to actually remain on the wood surface for a while, so that way the dyes can penetrate into the fibers, especially with woods that are very dense and tight fiber knit. So that way they have more opportunity to end up actually penetrating into the dyes or the wood surface. For this yellow, I'm going to end up shooting for about 0.05, 0.06. I may end up needing to add a little bit more yellow as I go. And the thing with this scale, it does go into the double decimal, into the hundredths, but it is a very touchy when it starts getting into the lower levels of weight. So I gotta kind of watch it. So I'm at 0.03. I'm gonna actually go to 0.05 because I don't wanna go more. And if I end up doing more, I'll go 0.06 then, because I did add a little extra blue to this formula. So the blue was the 0.045. So here I'm going with the 0.06 of this yellow. Then I'm just gonna add this to this mix as well. But anyways, so say that you're going for, you know, this aquamarine color, and you end up adding just a little bit too much yellow, and she ends up turning green on you. It's okay. You just may end up having to add a little more blue to bring the balance back to the blue spectrum. See, now this looks like it's gone to the green side. Oh, well, that's going to show up. But that's with 0.06 of the yellow. So this would probably be closer to almost like a green turquoise. Or something like that. But I'm going to end up adding just a little more blue again. Just because I'm pretty familiar with what this color is. I should have went with the 0.05. So anyway, so I'm going to go with 0.05 more of this blue. Try to put some on this piece here. So this is just a more solid piece. And this is going to be more of the type of piece of wood that I'm going to be applying this finish to. So let's just get this going and see what she looks like. Again, this is what the color of that stain looks like. I hope that shows up pretty good on the camera. You can see how it's kind of sticking to the back side of the spoon. Like if you would do this when you first mixed it up, it wouldn't stick that well. So that just basically comes with letting it sit for a little bit. Anyways, so here we go with the aquamarine on this piece here. I think I'm actually going to save a little section here because I want to do an orange, like a dark, I would say almost like a blood orange maybe. But maybe not a blood orange, like a dark orange brown. So let me save that little section for that. Maybe I should have just did a half and half, but oh well. I suppose I could use the other side. Oh, heck with it. We'll just do the whole thing. So again, I'm just laying this on this way. You don't have to do it this way. You can use a brush, you can use a cloth, you can use paper towel, which I do quite a bit myself. I just usually, on my first coat, I like personally to saturate it, to have a heavy excess built up on here, to really let the dyes have the opportunity and the chance to really dig into the wood. It's the introduction of the dye into the wood fibers. It's just my personal preference. You can actually do use the cloth as well. I think I'll just wipe off this excess then, and we'll let this dry up, and then we'll come back in a little bit and apply a second coat. So now I think these ends are going to end up having some fairly good figuring to it, where the center is just going to be a little more, you know, plain type wood. But again, this is, like I said, it's a pretty scraggly piece of wood. You can see here that there's some decay and stuff in it, but it's not that big of a deal for me. It's just a scrap piece that I'm working with, just to, well, one, to show some videos and have some scrap pieces are laying around, so when I want to check and test the color, I can just grab a couple pieces, chop it off with the saw, and sand her up, and have something, some type of substrate where I can end up actually testing the color. So anyways, I'm gonna let this dry, and I'll be back in a little bit to apply a second coat and then probably burnish it up. Okay, so this is fully dried. I'm just basically gonna run this paper toweling over this wood piece for a little bit, just to help get some of the loose dye that may be on the wood surface. Just get that out of the way. And actually this time I'm first of all gonna end up putting a glove on. And what I'm gonna do is I am going to just take a paper towel. And because this piece of wood has a lots of figure in it, let me just move this out of the way. Because this piece of wood has a lot of figure in it, I'm gonna actually take this dye stain now and I'm going to try to work it into this figuring a little bit more. Oh, I should have mixed that up. That should be okay. So you also notice that there is a lighter section right in here. So there's a couple things that we can do with that if I was really concerned with it. One thing I could do is instead of just hitting these ends, I could just hit the center portion instead and just keep building up the dye on this section. But I'm not too concerned with it. I think it adds character to the wood. That's just my personal opinion. Not everybody always agrees, so I'm just trying to help you understand a little bit. Okay, so this is the second coat. I'm just gonna get a little bit more on here. So this is the section here where I'm saying that I'm just gonna leave it a little heavier for it to dry. So hopefully that this darkens up a little bit more. I'm not too concerned. Like I said, this is just kind of a scrap piece, but I just like to have this center darkened up a little bit more. Because wood's a funny thing. It really takes any colorant, actually, unless it's paint, a certain way, based off the natural density and characteristics of the wood. So sometimes there's really not much that you can really do about it. And it really just comes down to the wood. Like I said, this is just a fairly low grade piece of wood. So, yeah, that would be good, I guess. Well, so you can see that there's a pretty big contrast between these ends and stuff like that, but it's a pretty nice color, I think. It's going to turn out fairly nice, actually. I think this centerpiece is going to end up adding to this piece itself. So, I'm going to let this dry out, and I'll be back in a little bit. Okay, so this is dried. I'm back. It looks like this has come out a little bit darker than originally I was going to anticipate. So, I guess you could end up adding a little bit more water or alcohol, or you could just reduce the amount of dye. But this is going to be a pretty cool color too, actually. So I'm just burnishing this now, just to try to help even the dyes out. It also helps give like this nice sheen to it, to the dyes. As you can, I don't know if that's going to show up very well. So anyways, there is no sealer on here yet, but I'm about to do that right now. Again, I'm just using lacquer. So it looks like it's going to be a dark. Almost like a teal color, I guess you could say. But it is also going to have some of that aquamarine color in these lighter areas here. Anyway, so I'm going to let this dry, and then I will come back, and I'll probably put a couple coats on here so that way you guys see what it looks like afterward. All right, so this is the final portion of this video. I apologize for the quality and for the duration of it. I'm actually not very good at making YouTube videos. I actually kind of get quite nervous when I make YouTube videos. But anyways, I hope that this helps people out. It's a little bit darker than I anticipated and originally wanted, but I also think that this is a good piece of wood that shows a pretty good representation of how the wood can really end up having an effect on the dye itself. So anyways, I hope that you guys like this video, and I'll try to get a couple more colors done, and I hope that this video actually helps somebody out that is looking to get this color. You can see that it is a pretty nice color. I really like how the dyes look on this piece of wood. So this is actually one of my favorite finishes, and my favorite colors using this Keda wood stain kit, the wood dye kit. And I hope that this helped out. All right, thanks, you guys.